This is a video for people who don't know how to get to Indian Wells Canyon. Coming from Ridgecrest, I find the best way to get there is to go up 395 first. And I'll show you, there's a turnoff up ahead. Canyon is to the left of Five Fingers there. Again, if coming from Ridgecrest, you go north on 395, and then there'll be a turnoff up ahead here. I forgot the name of the road. I'll tell you here shortly. I believe it's Atkins. It's coming up here shortly. Athel Street. Make a left on Athel Street. This is a shortcut. Instead of going through Inyokern, I find this is the easiest way to get to Indian Wells Canyon from Ridgecrest, to go on 395 and then make a left on Athel Street. And it heads straight toward Five Fingers, Athel Street. And Athel will tee on Highway 14 up ahead. And when we get to Highway 14, we're going to make cross Highway 14 and make a left on 14 and head south towards the Indian Wells Valley Lodge and Brewing Company. And the entrance to Indian Wells Canyon is just about 600 feet north of Indian Wells Valley Lodge. And I'll show you here shortly. Okay, we're coming up on Highway 14 here. And carefully come to a stop and look both ways. It's clear on the left here. I'm going to make a cross it. Five Fingers right up ahead. And I'm clear to the right, except there's a truck coming, so I better get moving. Okay, I'm heading south now on Highway 14. And we just go over this ridge line here. And we're almost at Indian Wells Valley Lodge. Just as we come over this ridge, the entrance is just ahead. So, okay, just as you come over the top of the ridge, you see the Indian Wells Valley Lodge ahead, and you see a stop sign up ahead, off to the right. That's where you want to go. This is the entrance to the Indian Wells Canyon. See the Indian Wells Valley Lodge down there? And here's the entrance to Indian Wells Canyon, your gateway to canyon adventure. We like this canyon. Indian Wells Canyon. Up here, and if you go far enough, you got the Native Magnolia Mining Camp. Lots of great hiking there. There's a turnoff to the Owens Peak Trail. Lots of great hiking there, and lots of other adventures up here, like hiking up Five Fingers. Okay, that's how you get here.
That particular area there is where the Native Magnolia Mining Camp is. There's a hill. One of my videos, I go to the top of that hill, Native Magnolia Hill. In another video, I go up to the top of that U there to see the plaque on the left side of Mount Jenkins. And another video I go to the top of George's View, that Bear Hill right there. And even in another video, I go up to Stensendero, which is that wooded hill right behind George's View. That's a lot of hiking adventures up in that area there. And then, if you go to the other side of Mount Jenkins, you see Owens Peak and the famous Owens Peak Trail going up to Owens Peak. And then on the ridgeline across from the parking area to Owens Peak, you'll see that field of boulders there. And you see, if you can see that one giant boulder in the center of that field of boulders on the side of the hill there, that grassy hill, under that giant boulder in the center of the screen is Indian pictographs. And there's another Indian pictograph site if you go up Owen Peak Trail. And it's about a mile up Owens Peak Trail just before you start making the ascent up to the right side of Owens Peak. So there's two pictograph sites in this view here. Looking the other direction, looking down the canyon. There's the road we came up. And there's the back side of Five Fingers. Showing a panorama. This is Indian Wells Canyon. Well, we're up at the end of SE 164, and it ends at the Owens Peak Trail. That's the Owens Peak Trailhead over there. And the trail runs up there and goes to Owens Peak. And that giant boulder right in the center of the screen, right under it, is Indian pictographs. To get to it, from the Owens Peak Trailhead, there's a little Jeep trail. It's blocked off, but you can walk into it right over there. And it goes all the way down to the bottom of this little valley here. And it ends at a spring down there. And at the spring, you make a beeline straight up to the rock. On your way up, you'll come across this flat rock in the center of the screen right now. That flat rock has lots of pestle grinding holes in it from the Indians from years ago grinding their nuts, pinion nuts, and oak. I guess they did oak nuts also, acorns, I mean, and pinions. Mostly pinions. And then just continue on up to that boulder, and right under that boulder you'll notice the Indian pictograph drawings. And speaking of other pestle grinding holes, this rock area where I'm parked at, if you go exploring around here, you also come across the Indian grinding holes, and we'll go do that right now. And just showing where this is at, near the Owens Peak Trailhead, which is over there. Come to this opening in the rocks, you go over right through here, from this opening in the rocks, you come to a little rock garden area with grinding holes.
located all around here. Interesting area. Huh? Wait a minute, I'll find a way to get down there. We want to go down that area there.
I think some people
camp here, yeah. Neat area to just explore and go climbing over these rocks. And you can use this rock as a tent.
Yeah, I think so.
I'll go in there. I don't see any pictographs under here. Well, what do you think, honey? No, I gotta find a way out. Hi, Ed. Well, that was interesting.
Can I go back? I'll take a picture of you?
No. Let's see what else to explore right here. Ooh. Probably lots more rocks down there. Well, that's enough exploring in the rocks for today. Top of Indian Wells Canyon on Thanksgiving Day weekend, Sunday, 2011. Oh, by the way, I have a geocache up here. So if anybody's interested in geocaching, it's called Majestic Indian Wells Canyon, or I believe Majestic IWC. Check it out. Oops.